been a great 2 days in San Juan. I got to meet some really inspiring people, had many good meals, and I also got to work on my tan. Today, I wake up bright and early, ready to explore La Union beyond Surftown. La Union is a 4-hour drive from Manila, and today, my first stop is the little-known Immuki Island in Balawan. I am told this is where you can find good quality sea urchin or uni, a prized ingredient in Japanese cuisine. Meet my guide, Marvin Maron, who knows everything there is to know about Immuki Island. If you come in the morning, remember to bring a sturdy pair of slippers because you are going to walk about 200 meters to the raft that will take you to the sea gardens. It's actually a very pleasant walk because the water is so clear and the sun still not too hot. We board the raft that takes us to where the fishermen cultivate sea urchin, seaweeds, and sea cucumber. Marvin explains to me how these three are an ecosystem within itself.
Ang seaweeds, kinakain ng sea urchin.
Okay.
And the sea urchin po, yung waste niya.
Yung waste.
Yung po ang kinakain ng sea cucumber.
Ah.
And then yung sea cucumber naman po, siya po yung naglilinis sa ilalim.
Wow, I didn't know that.
It takes 3 months before they can harvest sea urchins. They start off really small, the size of a 25 centavo coin, then grow to the size of a golf ball or a bit bigger. There are two kinds of sea urchins, the black variety or the panapana, and the colored variety or the maritangtang. Marvin says he prefers the panapana, which has a stronger flavor. Seaweed is also cultivated by the community to be sold, eaten as is, or made into achara.
Pwede nang kainin to?
Yes, sir.
Maalat, no? I can see the yung texture ng gelatin niya.
Yes.
Anong paborito niyo manong na pagkain niyan?
Yung tinatawag po dito yung kuan pasalad lang.
I always like to ask the locals how they enjoy their local delicacies. He tells me the best way to eat seaweed is to blanch it and mix it together with tomatoes, onions, and fish bagoong. That sounds absolutely delicious. Another way to enjoy seaweed is to make it into an achara or seaweed pickles. Mary Jane uses 3 kinds of seaweed that she has already blanched. She begins by boiling vinegar.
Anong klaseng vinegar yan?
Yung ano po, tubo po sir. Yung gawa dito sa La Union. Ituto namin po sa natin sa talangkang sa matunaw yung
sugar.
Sugar po.
So, natunaw na yung sugar.
Ginger. Pagsama-samahin na lang po natin,
sige,
sir.
Sige. Yung carrots, may arte pa eh, no?
Oo, sir. Para ma-attract naman yung mga...
Yeah.
The mixture is left to boil and then it becomes achara, a perfect companion to fried or grilled dishes. I like uni raw, straight from the sea, but here, they like to grill it.
You know, it really tastes like uni. It's a little bit salty, pero it's not as creamy anymore because of the, I suppose, nalagyan ng hita, no? Aha, okay.
Here's something else. The shell of the sea urchin can also be made into a soup.
So, paano kinakain? Diretsong ganyan lang yan? O may hinahalo with something, gano'n?
Typical po, pag yung gusto mo ng sabaw, inalagyan pa ng hot water, kamatis at sibuyas.
So yung laman lang?
Lahat po. Para matipid.
O, di mean lahat? Pati itong mga balat?
Yes, sir.
Ha? Kinakain yan?
Hindi po kakainin, pero yung lasa po niya nga.
Ikaw naman. Muntik mo ako na pasubo dun eh. Ikaw naman. Oh.
It's great how nothing goes to waste. The grilled sea urchin shells actually give a smoky flavor to the broth, and of course, there's the umami. Truth be told, I'm still partial to fresh uni. But when you visit Immuki Island, try both grilled and fresh uni, and do take home a bottle of achara. Thanks to all my friends in Immuki for that very warm welcome.
Okay naman ito, okay naman. Pero mga 4 kilos ito.
Not far from Immuki Island is River Farm Seafood Restaurant in Bacnotan, home of the Golden Tilapia. A visit to River Farm is more than a meal, it's an experience of enjoying a sumptuous spread on a raft while cruising along the clean and placid Baroro River. But wait, there I go again, getting ahead of myself. I am welcomed by Cesar Ocampo Jr., an architect by profession, but he has always helped out here at River Farm for as long as he can remember. Tilapia served at the restaurant is cultivated right here, so you can imagine how fresh your meal will be. Cesar asks me if I want to try my hand at fishing, and I say, why not? Piece of cake!
Nagamitin natin yung traditional fishing rod. Wisawis, okay. Tawag natin dito sa Ilocano.
Ano tawag?
Wisawis.
Wisawis. Oh, let's go.
Sige po, Chef.
Oh, exciting to. Yay! Maghuhuli kami ng dilis. Ewan ko na lang kung hindi ka pa makahuli rito. Diba?
Actually, it's harder than it looks. Even if there are hundreds of golden tilapia, it takes some time. Actually, quite a bit of time.
Yun na, yun na. Antayin nyo lang po, kagatin niya po.
Ah, ma-feel mo yan, no?
Yes, makakamdaman po siya, nakakagatin niya. Ayan niya, wala.
Ay, ayaw eh. Ayaw. Ay, wala na, oh.
Ang hirap pala nito. Oh, wait a minute. Eto na.
Wow! Wow! Ang laki naman ito, laki naman! Siguro mga 4 kilos ito. Oh, laki oh!
Joke lang, kulang pa sa appetizer ko yan. It's a good thing Cesar Sr. came to the rescue.
Una lulutuin natin ay steamed golden tilapia. Sunod natin yung fried golden tilapia and sinigang. And we have inihaw.
Cesar begins with the steamed golden tilapia, Chinese style. I noticed he uses local wine.
Fruit wine.
Wait. Yung products.
Anong klaseng fruit yan?
Nandito po na ginamit natin yung bawang
grape.
Bawang grape wine.
Okay.
Wine from bawang? How interesting.
Ano ito? Invento mo lang ito, Cesar?
Actually, may nagturo sa akin na galing Hong Kong.
Oh. So Chinese siya?
Yes, Chinese siya.
Cesar, among the tilapia, yung pagkaluto, anong favorite mo?
Inihaw.
Inihaw ka?
Ilocano ako eh.
Bakit? So sinabi mo Ilocano ka. So, what does that mean?
Healthy.
Healthy.
Tsaka madaling i-prepare.
Anong hinahalo mo doon? Salt lang?
Salt lang po.
Mga pang-pagana mo?
Pagana ay bagoong, calamansi. Konting sili.
Wow. Napalunok ako ron
ah. Okay itong si Cesar magluto. Parang master chef. Tilapia four ways. All at the same time. Ang galing din ni Cesar mag-plate. Look at that. Steamed golden tilapia in Chinese sauce. Sweet and sour fried tilapia. Inihaw na tilapia. And sinigang na tilapia. I've been meaning to ask though, what is the difference between golden tilapia and the more common black tilapia?
Yung golden tilapia po natin, may special po siya. Considered na po siyang saltwater tilapia. Very resilient po siya compared sa ibang variant na tilapia. Its flesh, napakalambot. And then wala siyang malansang na aftertaste na lasa.
fresh and napakalambot. Thanks for the description, Cesar. Nagutom na tuloy ako. Let's eat! Let's start with Cesar's favorite, inihaw na tilapia.
You know what? The inihaw na tilapia is so fresh. You know what the major difference really is when eating tilapia? You cannot get any fresher than this. All you have to do is clean it, inihaw, Chinese style, and fried. That's it. It's so good. Sarap.
Okay, my favorites. The inihaw na tilapia with my favorite pako salad, kamatis and bagoong, the fried tilapia as well, and the tilapia sinigang with just the right amount of sourness. Today feels like National Tilapia Day.
You know, you come here to a place like this for the scenery. You can go fishing, the kids can go fishing, you can eat what you catch, and you can take a boat ride while having your meal here. What an experience, diba? Sarap, tsaka masarap.
The river cruise on your very own floating nipahat is about an hour long. Perfect for a leisurely lunch while enjoying the fresh air and the scenic views. This is something I would definitely do again.
It's okay, may buto. Yung buto, lunukin mo na lang.
Grapes grew in La Union. Passing through the highway on my way to San Fernando from Bacnotan, I noticed signs that said, grape picking. Curiosity got the better of me, so I stopped to find out what it was all about. What I discovered was an actual vineyard where grapes are grown for winemaking right here in Bauang, La Union.
King, usually, yung picking grapes is between mga March to April, no? But they say you can grow grapes all year round, so I guess it's not weather dependent, diba?
When picking grapes, you have to cut the entire bunch like this.
This one, okay, you have a basket, and you just cut the... Yun, ayun na. Oh, tira mo. Yan na yun, no? Medyo firm siya, oh. It's nice and firm. Ewan ko ba't niyayakot ko itong poste. You know, actually, this is a great activity for the family, di ba? So, makakatuwa naman, no? Yeah, look at this. Like this one, oh. Itong bunch na ito. Yan. Oh, ayan, di ba? Tikman natin. Actually, I expected it to be sour. It's not that sour. May sweetness din siya. It's okay, may buto. Yung buto, lunukin mo na lang. Pero okay, ah. It's actually okay.
After filling your basket, you go to the counter to have it weighed.
Magkano ang kilo niya? 300. Pwede 320 na lang.
Oo, sir.
Ay, tata. Yan.
Ayan,
sakto. Ayos.
So why are grapes grown in La Union? We have Bauang native Avelino Lomboy to thank for that. Also known as the Grape King of the Philippines, he began propagating grapes as a hobby in the 1970s, proving that grapes indeed could be grown in our country. That's him right there, and look at who else has been here. Ako na lang yata din nakapunta dito. Avelino Lomboy passed away in 2018, but his legacy remains in the many vineyards found all over Bauang, successfully growing different grape varieties. Lomboy Farm's Uvas Cafe is an oasis on a hot day like today. It's bright, airy, and spacious with a great view of the vineyards. To have something like this in La Union is amazing. You can almost imagine you're in Tuscany. For those who want to experience wine tasting, there is a spread of exotic wines and appetizers. The late Avelino Lomboy said, "If you can successfully grow grapes, you can grow any other crop." He not only did that, he also made these crops into wine. He made wine from guava, watermelon, grapes, Kalinga coffee, and dragon fruit. What I had my eye on though was the grape soda. I'm not a big wine drinker, especially at 3 in the afternoon. So I had the grape soda instead.
This is the signature grape soda of Uvas Cafe. Masarap ah. Galing.
It was a simple drink with just a few ingredients. Soda, grapes from their farm, mint and lemon juice, but it just hit the spot. Really, really good.
Oh, masarap siya. Sarap.
Be sure to bring home a bottle or two of local wine for your family and friends. Cheers!
I love pancit. This is very, very well-made pancit.
Halo Halo de Iloko is a favorite among locals and tourists. For its ambiance, as well as for Chef Xavier's take on Ilocano food. The concept behind Halo Halo de Iloko is a museum and restaurant. Look around and you will find many items used for fishing and farming in the Ilocos region. Chef Xavier Mercado started Halo Halo de Iloko when he was only 22 years old. Today, almost 15 years later, Halo Halo de Iloko is a San Fernando institution that showcases the best of La Union produce. I'm here for a delicious merienda of 3 items on Chef Xavier's menu that keep people coming back again and again. Pancit and Grande, Okoy Tikyosko, and Halo Halo.
Alam mo, whoever created this Xavier, talaga bilib ako sa imagination niya, yung creativity niya. Tapos itong pancit niya has a lot of ricado, mixture of canton and bihon, and he boils the bagnet or the pork. Napapalunok ako. In buko juice. Tignan mo yung creativity ng tao, no? Grabe. Teka muna. Let me try this. You know, I'd like to say, I'm an expert in pancit. I love pancit. This is very, very well-made pancit.
I found out from Chef Xavier that here in La Union and maybe in the Ilocos region, instead of toye and calamansi, they eat their pancit with sukang Iloko.
Okay, now, mukha natin with sukang Iloko. Sarap nito, mau. Iba yung amoy ng sukang Iloko talaga. Tama, umuusok pa, oh. Alam mo, I'm sure yung broth nito is so different because the noodles are so tasty and actually in any pancit, the secret is in the broth eh, di ba?
It had everything I love in a pancit. Bagnet, liver, fish balls, hard-boiled egg, and a lot of veggies.
It is really a pancit in grande. Napaka, napaka. Napakasarap.
Another Halo Halo de Iloko favorite is Okoy Tikyosko, made with squash, kamote, shrimps, and flour. Masarap din. So ganito style ko dyan.
You get a little of the vinegar, put it on the okoy. I'll show you like this. Okay. May maliliit na hipon eh. Sili. Lagay mo jam. Tapos patuloy mo yung suka dun sa pancit.
Ang anghang. Winner. Winner to.
You know what else was a winner? This. Look, it even has my name carved on it.
Wow, ang sarap nito. May pinipig doon. Mmm, ang sarap niya.
You may think all halo-halo are made equal, but they're not. Halo Halo de Iloko is also famous for their fried halo-halo, another of Chef Saver's inventions. Best enjoyed with a scoop of ube ice cream. Naimas! I head back to Surftown to enjoy my last sunset in La Union. I was so surprised. I had a blast. Thank you, La Union. What a terrific 3 days it's been. Breakfast, lunch, dinner repeat, repeat, repeat. The smiles, the laughter, inspiring people, and great stories. Ang sarap nito. We're all in this together, and I believe fellowship and good food will see us again through.
Very, very good.
Wherever you may be, stay safe, be well. This is Sandy Daza. Thanks for...